God this morning for waking us up, for letting us see another day. God is just so good this morning. This morning, He is just awesome, God. God was dealing with me on some things from Sunday, from church, and the word that we got about don't miss out on your destiny. And God had been dealing with me with following the Holy Spirit, instead of your heart. And so that's what I'm going to talk about this morning, is don't miss your destiny and follow the Holy Spirit and not your heart. Because that heart, oh Lord, it will get us in some trouble. So this morning, God, we thank you this morning, God. We thank you for waking us up, God. We thank you for starting us on our way. God, we thank you for your love, your grace, your mercy, your kindness, God. We thank you right now in the name of Jesus, God. Let me decrease, God, and let you increase in me this morning, God. Oh, glory to God, because I don't want it to be me, God, but I want it to be you, God, that you will get the glory out of my life. And God, people will hear your word, not Patina, but we'll hear your word. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. Hallelujah. Well, thank God and bless God for you this morning. Hallelujah. He has been so good. I love the Lord because He's always given revelation. He's always giving me something to talk about. Because I was just saying, I was late this morning. I'm not going into work. And so I got up late, didn't get a chance to pray like I like to do. But however, I was like, well, God, do you want me to go on? And He said, yeah, because He had already given me something to say. And as we know, I'm just going to talk about don't miss your destiny. And follow the Holy Spirit, not your heart. There's a story in the Bible that we are all familiar with, too familiar with, and that is Samson and Delilah. And that's at this time, Samson came along because the children of Israel began to start worshiping idol gods. And so God allowed them to one more time to be passed under the power of the enemy. And this enemy was the Philistines. See, this war between the Philistines and the Israelites, so the Israel and the Philistines, that has been going on way before now. It's all the way back in the Old Testament. And when, so they've been having this war before we were even thought of. So it didn't just start. So at this time, and they were strong, the Philistines were very strong. They had an army. They came in to Israel. They took everything. They stole. They couldn't fight because they had all of their swords, their food, their everything. So but the children of God begin to cry out to God. And don't you know that God will, if you cry out to Him, that He will come. When you are in distress, that God will come when you call. So the children of Israel cried out to God again and asked God to help them. So there was a man called Manoah, which is Samson's daddy. And he came to his wife, Samson's mother. And the angel came to unto Samson's mother and said, you shall have a son, and when he grows up, he will begin to save Israel from the hand of the Philistines. But your son must never drink any wine or strong drink as long as he lives. And his hair must be allowed to grow long and must never be cut. For he shall be a Nazarite under a vow, under the vow to the Lord. So a Nazarite means one who has a vow, consecrated, separated. And I believe because we have the Holy Spirit now, because Jesus has died, he has risen from the dead. So this was back in the Old Testament before Jesus had come. So I believe that now we are all Nazarites. When we say that we have taken that vow to the Lord, that we say that we are children of God, that we have confessed our sins, that we have decided to follow Jesus and Him alone. So I believe once we become saved and we have made that vow unto the Lord, then we become just like Samson. We have been consecrated. We have been separated. We have been set aside for Jesus and His word. So God came to Samson. The angel came to Samson and told Samson's mother that she will have this child. And as we all know the story about Samson and what happened to him, he met this woman named Delilah. And you know the story of how since she kept on bothering Samson, she kept on messing with Samson until he told her the secret of his power. And we know what happened to Samson when he told her the secret about his power. Now, first of all, Samson wasn't supposed to be messing with Delilah. Delilah was a Philistine. He wasn't supposed to be messing with her, but he had to have her. He had to have her, and so he went against what God had told him to do. He went against his purpose and his destiny. And this is the reason what God was saying, because in this season, it's very important for us saints, for us people who have said that, God, we are yours, Lord, that God, we have made that vow. There are some things in order for us to get to that destiny that God has said for us in our lives. But so many times we want to follow the heart and not the spirit. There were many times in where I almost missed my destiny, hallelujah, because I wanted to follow even in me moving to Atlanta. I was following my heart and not the spirit. I was just trying to get away. I was just trying to get away. I wasn't thinking about God. I wasn't thinking about what He had said. First of all, I didn't hear nothing that He had said. So in this season, God is saying, in order for us not to miss our destiny, because isn't that what Samson did? Because he had to have her. And so what happened was, and how many of us got some Delilahs in our lives where we got to have it? And so what God has been dealing with me on about following the Spirit of God and not our heart. Because so many times we want to go after the things that we feel, that we are emotional, that those things that we got to have, those things that we feel like they're very important in our lives, that we got to have. But God is saying no. So Samson didn't fall unto temptation. In the terms of what it said on here, it didn't say he was drinking, right? So it said he wasn't supposed to drink, so he wasn't drinking. It didn't say anything about him having sex or being with a woman. It didn't say anything about that. It says not taking unto wine and strong drink, and do not cut his hair. So maybe maybe he wasn't thinking that if he got with somebody that he wasn't supposed to get with, maybe he was thinking that that would be okay. So sometimes, isn't that what we'll do? We'll think because, well, God didn't specifically say this. So he didn't say that, so I can go this way. So even in him going that way, look what happened. He ended up being with the enemy. Because he got weak. And he told it to her. So there is, make sure that we're very careful not to miss our destiny. Because we are following the things after our heart and not after what God has said. Because let me tell you something, it's tough. Because you got to be in that place where you're listening to God and not man. You have to be in that place where you are making sure that you have the ear of God. The ears that you're listening to what God is saying over what man was saying. I just dealt with this situation because I was asking God, well, God, do you want me to be here? But I was so excited where I was in church and different things. And I was just like, it's so exciting. I just love it. But God was saying that, no, I want you to be here. Yes, 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 yes. But my heart was there. Because everything seemed to be the way I love it. Everything seems to be the way I like it. Everything seems to be like I like it. There were also another scripture in the Bible where Adam and Eve. And we're going to beat that horse because the thing about it is that we still are doing the same thing today. The enemy has no new tricks. Where they miss out on what God had called them and purpose for them to do. They were not supposed to eat of that fruit. They was not supposed to do it. And look what happened. It altered time and everything and destiny for all of us. Because it brought in sin. So we can look back at some of the decisions that we have made because we followed our heart. I'm one of them. Because I went against what God had said for his word in his word. And see, this is the thing that God had been dealing with me on, is that so many times what we do is we want to justify it. Oh, well, because I love this person and I don't think I'll never find nobody like them. And I don't care what sex they are. Y'all know I came up out of that homosexual, you know. Kim Burrell didn't say it. God said it, okay? Let's get that straight. Now, maybe her delivery could have been a lot nicer. But let me tell you something. She didn't say it. God said it. Because I too did the same thing. Because I wanted to follow the lust of the flesh. I wanted to follow that. So what I did was I made that decision. Because I was being led with my heart. But not on the word of God and what God had said for Pratita in her life. I can't talk about nobody else, but through my testimony, I can help somebody else. Because there are many of us on this decision this year. And the reason why God is sending out these messages, I'm sure y'all are hearing prophetic word about this message, about what God is going to do for you this year. So guess what? God is trying to get this stuff out in January. So that nobody has an excuse. Nobody has an excuse, because many times what we want to do is we want to be lukewarm saints. We want to believe in the word. We want to talk about we love the Lord and we know about the Bible and we go to church occasionally and we read our word occasionally or whatever. But a lot of us have not said, you know what, God, I'm going to turn this thing around this year, God, because there are some things that I want. And the only way I know that I'm going to get them is I have to be on your side 100%. You cannot be on this side of the fence and then on that side of the fence in order to fulfill your destiny. It's just not going to happen this season. So what Samson did, what he did, was he missed his destiny. That's why he was created, y'all. We all were created for a purpose. But so many times we allow the enemy through whatever avenue. The enemy don't play fair. He starts coming after us when we're in our mother's womb. He started coming after my family, hallelujah, before my family was a family. My parents, Bishop Harvey Hutchinson and Marilyn Monroe, before I was even created. Divorce is death. So what happened in divorce, hallelujah, it caused the death. So then what happened was it began to alter our path. That's what divorce does. There were things that Pratina was supposed to do. There were things that Miranda was supposed to do. There were things that Tashanda, Joshua, and Jeremy. But when the enemy came in and divided and shifted our family, then guess what started to happen? A shift. A shift. And that's what happens in our lives when we're not going in the direction that God said for our lives. God said, go this way, but you want to go that way. You want to go this way. And God is saying that in order for us to get to where God is taking us in this season, we got to get it right here. So what I'm asking you this morning, in order to get to that place in God, to get to that place in God, what God is saying this morning is go back. Go back and begin to look at your life. Begin to see some areas where it seemed that you knew what God was telling you, but you decided because you was listening to this person and you was listening to that person and you knew what God was saying for your life. So that you do not miss God in this season. Because the enemy, he don't want you to get there. He don't want me to get there. How many of us have followed the Spirit? I mean, not the Holy Spirit, but felt that the love of that person and we were passionate about something or someone. We had to have it. And it was not the will of God, the plan for God for our lives. We had in our, hallelujah, we have the power that's in us that God has given each and every one of us. That's the season that we're in. God is going to give you everything that he said he's going to do, but you got to make sure that you're lining up with him and his will and purpose for our lives in this season. We got to put on the whole armor of God. If you know that there were things that you're not supposed to be doing, stop it. Get it right. But so many times, that's exactly what we want to do. I wanted to do everything that I failed. I wanted to be with a woman, so I was with a woman. We as saints, y'all, I'm talking about believers. I'm not talking about people who don't believe in God. I'm not talking about for the people who don't believe in the Bible, in the Word. I'm not talking about, this ain't for you then. But this is for the people that say that they believe in the Bible. They believe in Jesus Christ. So guess what? You have to eat the whole loaf. You can't eat half of the loaf. You have to eat the whole thing. I had to eat it. So many times, that's what we want to do. We want to, we're some wishy-washy people. I know I was. Oh, this is hard. This is hard. I don't want to do it. I don't want to get up all the time. I love it now. But in the beginning, yes, it was difficult because God was cleaning me up. He was molding me. He was shaping me. In that process, it does not feel good, y'all. But let me tell you something. You're going to be better for it in this season. You're going to be better for it because God is coming with power. And he's saying, for those that have kept my word, for those who have kept the faith, for those who have stood even when times were hard, God is going to reward you. He said he's a rewarder of those who diligently seek him. He is a rewarder of those. Be ye steadfast, unmovable, always standing. You have to be steadfast, y'all. We cannot be lukewarm saints anymore. So the two things or three things this morning is don't miss your destiny. Follow the Holy Spirit and not your heart. God has a plan for your life. He has a plan for my life. He wants us to be victorious. And stop allowing the enemy to come in like Samson did. Like so many others, even throughout the Bible, even in your life where you knew you were supposed to go this way, but you went the other way. There's a song, I love this song, and my grandma used to sing it, and now I really understand it. I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. No turning back, no turning back. And then it says, you could have this whole world, but give me Jesus. You can have this whole world, but give me Jesus. You can have this whole world, but give me Jesus. No turning back, no turning back. We got to decide that in this season, we going to be on the Lord's side all the way. All the way. We're not going to go this way. We're not going to go that way. We're going to go straight. Because we got to be in the shift that's about to happen. See, God is shifting. So he's not here because that's just like the other week. God was giving me that if you seek him, you will find him. And that God is not where he was 10 seconds ago. He's not where he was 10 minutes ago. That God is shifting. And in order for us to move with the shift, we got to be in line. So when he goes this way, we right there with it. When he go that way, we right there with it. Because if we don't, we're going to miss God and we're going to be like this. And we're going to miss it. And we're going to miss it. So get them Delilahs out your life. Get them Delilahs out your life. Quit holding on to stuff that you know that God didn't have in plan for your life. It's either you can get it at the beginning of this season, this year, or you're going to miss it. So get them negative talks, them negative people out your life. Those things. Some of us, not just people, some of us put trust in things. So we got to get those things out of our life too. How can you be concentrated? Created. And this is what a lot of people battle with this in the church about drinking and strong drinks and different things. Because I occasionally, you know, drink my wine, or, you know, I love wine, you know. But a man of God came and talked to me, and I know it was God because I never met the man before in my life. And I never met him. I was just talking to him as a prophet on the phone. And I had just had, it was Tuesday. And I had a glass of wine, like, on that Sunday evening. And he came to me. I'm so transparent because I don't care what people, I think about what God think about me. And so he told me, he said, woman of God, he said, you a prophet. And where God is getting ready to take you, he said, that glass of wine that you had on the other day, that's going to be your last. And I started laughing. I was like, oh my God. And I was like, really? I said, well, I did. And I was just like, oh my God. So I understand now why he said that. When you're in consecration and when you're on assignment for God, you can't be in anything that's going to alter that. You can't be drinking a strong drink that's going to alter that. So I get it now. I understand. So that's why God was saying those things. There are some things that y'all, everybody, you can't do what everybody else can do. Samson couldn't. A lot of us have been set aside for a specific assignment, for a specific purpose, just like Samson was. And there are certain things that you cannot do. And if you're battling with it, then you already know. You already know what it is. I remember when I used to be at Pastor Beverly Crawford and Pastor Todd Crawford's church. I grew up around Pastor B, and they were there when I was born. They've known me all my life. And so I remember her talking about many years ago how when she used to wear pants, and she said that she had to stop wearing pants because it wasn't nothing wrong with wearing pants. It wasn't nothing wrong with women wearing pants. But she said because she had to stop wearing pants because she liked the way it made her get attention. This is when she was young and in the ministry and when she was an evangelist. And she just started out. And so God had told her she had to stop wearing pants because of what it did to her and how it made her feel. So at that time, God shifted her because he did not want her to be tempted by anything. So what God did was he told her, don't wear pants. So she didn't wear pants anymore. At that time in her life, now I'm sure she wear pants. She might not wear a whole lot of pants, but I'm sure she does now. But at that time in her life, God had shifted in order for her to get to where God was trying to take her. So there's things in our lives, in order to get to our destiny, in order for us to get there, we gonna have to stop. God is saying this morning, it's either you're in or you're not. No more going back and forth. Just do what God tells you to do. And I guarantee you, if you do that, obedience is better than sacrifice. Obedience is better than sacrifice. There are examples like Whitney Houston. Everybody know Whitney Houston should have been singing gospel. That's what she was created here. That woman had a voice of an angel. She was created to sing for God. But what the enemy did was he got her linked up with secular. Clive Davis. Because as long as she was in the church, singing in the church, God kept her. And then she started getting into places and going into places that she shouldn't have went into. She got involved in doing certain things that she should have done. And it altered the course of her life. So because God said, well, if you're going to continue to do this, then I'm going to take you. So her life was cut short. Her destiny, y'all, don't you see? Her destiny was cut short. God has a plan for our life here. And that plan is for godly. It's for God. It's for him. It's for his godly assignment, for kingdom building. So I pray this morning, because I don't want to keep beating the head dead horse, that you receive. And whoever watches this today, God, or throughout the day, who's watching it now, I see you, Ty, and Martin, and Wanda, that we do what God has called us to do. Hey, my beautiful niece. In order for us to fulfill our destiny, In order to fulfill your destiny, don't miss the shift. Get in line with God. Don't be like Samson and so many other people that go contrary to what God has called and purposed for us to do. Follow the Holy Spirit, not your heart, not the emotions, not all of that stuff that comes up in the heart. Because the heart has been hurt. The heart has been rejected. The heart is going through so much, so we can't follow the heart. We have to follow the Spirit. So dear Heavenly Father, God, right now in the name of Jesus, God, Lord, I thank you for your word. God, I thank you for this right now word for this season. For the people of God, that God, for every person, God, that hears this, God, that you will begin to do a new thing in them, God. That God, in the name of Jesus, that you will wake up in them the passion and the things of God, and hallelujah, the destiny, the purpose, God, for their lives. And that God, that they won't go the way that you're not, God, that they will only want to walk the line and where you are, God. That God, that they will move in the shift in the things of God, that they won't be lukewarm, God, that God, they will be all in. That God, you will begin to open up their understanding of the things of God and the things that you have for them. God calls them to begin to get on their knees and pull away the table, God. Begin, oh God, God, that they will begin, hallelujah, to seek you like never before, Lord. That old things will pass away, and behold, all things become new. That God, that they will begin to get in their word, because God, you have given them, everyone, the measure of faith. That God, that you have given it to them, God. You have given them their godly assignment for their lives, God. And God, let them begin to run. To run this race that you have set before them. And that, God, that you will keep them. And that you will guide them, God. And Lord, we ask that you bless the people that are getting up and ready to go to work and on the highways and the byways, God. That you will bless each and every one today, God. And that it will be a great day. God, I love you, God. And I give your name the praise. I give your name the honor. I give your name the glory, God. In Jesus' holy and righteous name I pray. Amen and amen. God bless you guys. Love you.